There's a huge misconception about what reading is. A lot of people think that you read to retain information because in school, that's what they teach you to do. They say, hey, read this book, read this textbook, and try to memorize each and every detail because guess what? We're going to test you on it. This isn't reading. This is called studying. In reality, you read to train your mind the same way working out trains your body. Only instead of breaking down your muscle fibers by applying pressure and growing them back stronger, you're literally rewiring the neurons, the fibers of your brain, into a stronger, more aligned version of itself. A version that is more capable of lifting the weights that life provides. Just like how when you work out, you become more capable of lifting the weights in the gym. A lot of people get these brief, sporadic inspirations to read. They read an entire book in a day or two, and then they don't read for another 3 months. But this is equivalent to doing a full body workout for 4 hours in one day and not working out for another 3 months. If you asked any person who is even slightly involved in the fitness field, they will all unanimously say, you're not going to see results. You're not going to see any results. The only way to see results is through consistency. It is the one habit that you should be doing. The most important of all habits, more important than working out, more important than eating right, more important than sleeping. Because when you make reading into a habit, it will give you benefits that will bring you to planes way higher than a bombshell body can ever do.
Today, I'm going to tell you how long it takes to read the Bible. A lot of people are wondering that. Kind of the common answer you hear is if you read 3 chapters a day, you'll get through it in a year. Or if you read 1 chapter a day, you'll get through it in 3 years. Couple givens. One, the average person reads about 250 to 300 words a minute. Now, let's say we're chugging along at the low end of that, and so we're reading about 250 words a minute. The Bible is about 800,000 words long. That would take us 3,200 minutes or thereabouts to read through the entire Bible, which is 54 hours. Which means if you're reading the Bible 15 hours a day, which will still give you 8 hours to sleep, 1 hour to eat, take a shower, or whatever, 15 hours a day, you will get through the entire Bible in less than 4 days. So let's say that we read just half an hour a day. That's no problem. You're looking at reading the Bible in less than 4 months, which means in 1 year, you're going to read through the entire Bible cover to cover 3 times.
You know, the Bible says in Hebrews 4:12 that the Word of God is living and active. It's sharper than any two-edged sword. And that means that the Bible literally pulsates with life. We may read other books, but the Bible reads us. And even though it's 2,000 years old, it's still the best-selling book of all time. Did you know that between 1815 and 1975, over 2.5 billion copies were sold, and even today, it is still the number one bestseller. 1 Peter 1, 24 and 25 says, "The grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of the Lord endures forever." Now, when we read the Bible, we don't read it like other books. It is inspired, which means God breathed, and it is God's primary way of speaking to us. And every time you come before the Word of God, it is an opportunity for your life to change. The same God who spoke the universe into existence and caused the stars to shine, the planets to orbit on their axis, is the same God who spoke His Word into the Bible that we now hold in our hands. You know, God chose to inspire the writing of it through human authors. And there was this guy who had already been through, he had already received the Bible, and he came back to get a second one. He said, actually, the pages of your Bible is just perfect for me to tear out and to roll my marijuana and smoke my joints with. I did what you told me. Before I tore out the page and rolled it to smoke one of my joints, I read every single word on that page. He said, okay, well, tell me what happened. The man said, well, I smoked my way through Matthew. I smoked my way through the book of Mark. I smoked my way through Luke. But then I got to the Gospel of John, and the book of John smoked me, and I have given my heart and life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Friend, that is the power of the Word of God. And the more you expose yourself to it, the more you allow its power to transform your life.